Sidney, wonderful to have you back on American Thought Leaders.
Oh, it's great to be with you. Thank you.
So, you know, you wrote a town hall article recently talking about this, let's call it a spectacle.
Yeah, that's a good
of, of Michael Cohen hearing on the same day that the president was in some very delicate negotiations in Vietnam with North Korean dictator Kim Jong-un. Tell us a little bit about your perspective here.
Well, the first thing I noted, of course, was that Mr. Cohen is projecting when he calls the president certain names. It's like he's describing himself instead of the president. It was just remarkable, and the Democrats seem to do that all over the place.
It's a well-established and documented fact that he's a serial liar.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. And I think the only mistake the president really made there was ever hiring that kind of person to be his legal counsel in the first place. My guess is he was trying to give the man an opportunity, and it wound up biting him. But yes, Mr. Cohen has at least established that there's absolutely no evidence of collusion. He had none whatsoever, so he has shot the collusion theory dead in the water when they thought he was going to help them with that. He also completely debunked any notion that he was ever in Prague, and I believe he was telling the truth on that. I think that's particularly significant because, you know, the Steele dossier said Michael Cohen was in Prague.
Yep.
I think that came from Fusion GPS mining the NSA database because I believe Comey gave illegal access. Well, I know he gave illegal access
right.
to three private contractors. We know that from the FISA court decision
right.
that was unsealed, although heavily redacted.
A lot of evidence pointing towards
yeah,
Fusion being one of them.
Yeah, I would bet money that one of those private contractors was Fusion GPS, and that's how the wrong Michael Cohen evidence was in Prague wound up in the Steele dossier.
I see.
Courtesy of Nellie Orr feeding it to Bruce on the thumb drive and then to the FBI.
Right.
Yes, so that's shot dead now. Michael Cohen was not in Prague. And yeah, it's just kind of one thing after the other got shot in the foot the other day.
Fascinating.
Yes, and then of course we have the Democrats getting so excited about this whole election law violation when not even Michael Cohen is guilty of the election law violations he pled guilty to. In fact, I have challenged any lawyer in the country to cite a single case that serves as precedent for the criminal violations that Michael Cohen pled guilty to under the election laws. There is not one.
So you think he was kind of pressured into pleading guilty for that as opposed to...
No doubt. He was completely set up and coerced into pleading guilty to those election law violations as a means of trying to smear the president again with that kind of allegation so they can charge the conspiracy or assert a conspiracy, try to impeach him with a conspiracy, whatever. But no, those are not election law violations under any stretch. Meanwhile, of course, we have President Obama having had $2 million or more in election law violations that was handled with the $375,000 civil fine.
Right. So there were, you know, the thing that jumped out at me from the, let's say, the general mainstream headlines had to do kind of like a character assassination on the president.
Oh, it was slanderous.
Yeah.
It
yeah.
was absolutely slanderous. But, you know, even Cohen had to say, no, there are no tapes of anything. There's nothing anybody can blackmail him with. And Lord knows if anybody would have known about any of that, it would have been Michael Cohen. Heck, he would have generated himself. You know, all the tapes he was supposed to have of incriminating conversations with the president.
Right.
Well, there's none of that.
Nothing exists.
Nothing. He's got nothing. And the Democrats have nothing. But are they going to stop? No, they're going to keep going. But as I said somewhere the other day, the Democrats have the donkey as their symbol for a reason. And lately, they've been acting like the southbound end of the northbound donkey.
But so, I mean, basically what you're telling me that the way these Cohen hearings played out is there was a whole bunch of unsubstantiated slander. And at the same time, there was some valuable evidence that actually supports the president.
Yes.
And well, any other fallout?
I think that pretty much sums it up.
Okay.
It was a slander show and otherwise supports the president.
Fascinating. Well, Sidney, wonderful to have you back. I look forward to having you back with us sometime in the future.
Thank you. Anytime, Jan. It's a pleasure,
Such
always.
Such a pleasure.
Thank you.